I am so excited to bring you today's meal. Starting out, this first meal idea I am not going to make here on camera, but for the meal, it's 2 packets of these fruit and cream, whatever flavor. It's the variety pack. These were so cheap, $1.67 per box. And then I'm going to add a Dannon Light and Fit yogurt to it. And that is going to be a snack that I'm going to take with me to work and just make on the go. That's why I'm not sharing with you today, because I don't need to meal prep that. Meal idea number 2 is 4 meals in total. We are doing a spaghetti with roasted cauliflower, just a jar red sauce, and some Beyond sausage. Now, all of these meals are high protein just because that's just what I prefer. But if you want to save a bunch of money, you could substitute the proteins for something else or just omit them altogether. Meal number 3 is 9 meals in total. We are going to do a sausage pancake bake with a side of eggs, just something really simple that I can put together in a meal prep container and take on the go. That's really all this is. Meal number 4 is 12 meals in total. It's been a really long time since I've made a 2-ingredient style biscuit or a bagel of any kind. We're making biscuits today just to save us a few minutes when it comes to prepping. And I actually have a lot of leftover ingredients left over after making these meals. I have flour, I have yogurt. What else do I have left over? I don't know. I could probably have made more than 33 meals. All right, so let's get prepping. In total, with filming, cleaning my kitchen, doing the dishes, all the prep, it was 1 hour and 15 minutes. So it realistically, making 33 meals, that sets me up for success. The only thing I have to make this week is dinners, and I kind of have that on dial in, really, really easy dinners. We'll go over that later. If you would like to know my whole meal plan for the week, I can probably put together a video of it. But for starters, we're doing 12 eggs, 2 cups of egg whites, whisking that together. And then I'm putting them in these silicone molds. And yes, I am spraying them. And you're probably wondering, why are you spraying them? They're silicone. The last 2 times I've used them, the eggs have stuck so bad. So I've just like, you know what? This time I'm going to save my sanity. And yes, I did spray them. And then they were fine. So what I'm doing here is dividing everything as close to equal as possible into 12 portions, just because this is going on our homemade biscuit. The cool thing about these biscuits in total, with the eggs included, they are 19 grams of protein per meal. And like I said, I'm making 12 biscuits. I think that's a great way to set up either a snack, a lunch, or a breakfast. Moving on into the prep, we are doing the sausages. If you notice, I kind of cut everything specific to the meal. So for the one sausage, I have 8 pieces. For the other one, I have 12. There wasn't that's what it was. There was an additional sausage left over that I could have added to another meal, but I ended up eating that this day as I was meal prepping as like a snack. It was really good. All right, for the 2-ingredient biscuits, I've made these multiple different ways on my channel before. You can make them with plant-based yogurt if you want to. It's just equal parts yogurt and self-rising flour. If you don't have self-rising flour, you can make your own just by adding, I think it's baking soda, I think, now that I'm like questioning myself, 1 cup to 1 cup. So I'm doing 3 cups of yogurt to 3 cups of flour, and that should make 12 biscuits. You can also make bagels. I am not going to take the extra time to make bagels because I'm trying to go as fast as possible. We are racing the clock for baby's nap time. And like, yes, technically bagels would take me maybe an extra 5 or 10 minutes to roll them out. But that 5 or 10 minutes is like everything. My baby usually naps about 1.5 hours in the morning. And so me getting as much done as possible means I'm moving as fast as possible. We're racing against the clock. So if you look at this dough, it is a little bit drier. That's okay. Once it bakes up, it's super moist because of the yogurt. It's super high protein. I have a lot of questions if you can use gluten-free flour or whole wheat flour. Yes, you absolutely can. It's super up to you. I've used gluten-free flour before. They just take a little bit longer to bake, and you might need a little additional flour. So I'm just going to separate them really quickly, divide them into 12. I'm going to do an egg white wash, just do like a couple tablespoons of egg white, and then I have some everything seasoning I'm going to put on top. It's not actually everything bagel seasoning. It's just everything seasoning, so it's a lot more finer, but it's still pretty good. You can use anything you want with these. You can also add fruit if you want to. I've seen people do pumpkin. There's a ton of different recipes on TikTok, on Pinterest, so you can figure that out. But these are just the basic ones because, like I said, we're racing against the clock. I'm not taking a lot of time to do everything today. These also cook really, really quickly if you want to use the air fryer. I'm actually going to use the air fryer to reheat these on the go in like during the week. And if we don't make it through all 12 of them, which will actually shock me if we don't, because my husband will eat multiple of them. When I come and create meals for YouTube, I am doing it in a portion for myself. A meal is technically breakfast, lunch, or dinner. A lot of people would say this is a portion or a serving, but technically it's still a meal because I am one person sitting down eating a meal. But if we don't use through these this week, I'll pop them in the freezer and then we can put them in the air fryer from frozen. But to reheat them, I am going to put them into the air fryer. So they bake 350 degrees for 22 minutes. You can bump up the temperature to 425 for the last, I think it's 6 minutes, and brown them really well. I never do that just because I reheat them in the air fryer. I said, some quick egg wash. You can do egg white or egg wash and some seasoning, and we're good to go. Let me know down below, what are you meal prepping this week? What's something that saves you a lot of time? I do a lot of breakfast foods because that saves us the absolute most time. Plus, it's something we both always want, and I think personally, it's just something that reheats well. I need to have a lot more ideas because I'm getting like food fatigue, meal prep fatigue. I don't know. I feel like I'm walking around the grocery store some weeks, like, what do I make? And this was one of those weeks, and this is just what I came up with. All right, moving on. We are doing the pancake bake. I'm using the Krusty's protein pancake mix. This was on sale for $4, plus I had a coupon for $2, which I think is the best thing ever. Plus, I got some Fetch rewards on it, so it's like, bam, bam, bam. You have to buy it. So I'm just mixing it with some water. To be truthful, I'm just mixing it with eyeballing it with the water. I think I used 2.5 cups, but you can use more or less. You just want it to look like pancake batter. If you've never made a pancake bake before, you put it on a baking sheet sprayed with cooking spray. You spread it out. You pop it in your oven 350 degrees until it's baked completely through. It takes about 20, 25 minutes. And then what I did is just added the sausages, since this is 9 servings. And a meal with this is going to end up being, I think it was like 33 grams of protein or something like that. So it's a decent sized meal. But we're making 9 servings total. So I'm just putting the sausage on there to bake with it. And then when I cut it up, you'll see here in a little bit how I'm doing that. But I just thought that was like a fun, different way. I could have added the sausages to the eggs too. You know, doesn't matter how you do it. I just thought that was cool. All right, moving on. These are the eggs that are going with the sausage pancake bake meal. I'm just using the leftover ones. I didn't have to add this additional protein, but I did this for my husband. Obviously for me too, but I just thought it was a way to get more meals out of the pancake bake that were bigger, if that makes sense. But you could definitely use these eggs to make more of the protein bagels as well. Anytime I do meal prep, putting together the meals is my absolute favorite thing. It is so satisfying to me. I decided to use these little bags. They're like the foldable sandwich bags because we ordered something on Amazon like 2 weeks ago and they sent us these. And when I contacted support to like send them back, they're like, oh, just keep them. And I had no idea what to use them for. So I'm like, you know what? I'm going to use them for these breakfast sandwiches, which is wild because I think we ordered like butt cream or something for our baby, like diaper cream, and they sent us these. So just like the wrong SKU in the wrong place. I remember just really laughing about it. Like, and we got a huge box of them, like 1,000 of them. And I'm like, what do I do with them? But I think I found a place for them. All right, moving on. We're going to put together the rest of the meals. Again, the most satisfying thing ever, putting the pancake bacon, great idea to add the sausage. Thought that was really great. Added the eggs. I get a question all the time, like, what does your husband eat? He'll eat the same things. I just portion them out for my portion, and he'll either eat 2 or 3 meals. I say this all the time, but I think people just miss it, maybe because it's towards the end of the video, or they're just not paying attention, but I always get comments, what does your husband eat? Same thing. Very easy. I just make meals on Sundays and Wednesdays usually, so that way nothing goes to waste. And then I decide with this meal to add some pancake syrup, like this is like a tablespoon, because this is a 2 ounce container. Not very much, but just a little bit to add to the pancake bake. Really love this. Did not include this in the cost overall because I had this in my pantry. But again, it's not something you don't have to use if you don't want to. And these meals would freeze great too. I know a lot of people don't love like frozen eggs. We used to order meal prep like this from a company that's no longer around, but they would always have like a breakfast option and they always had everything frozen and it reheated really well. I guess I'm just not that picky. It's not that deep to me. Anyways, I will link these containers down below. They are a great price. You can get 50 of them for like $20, which is awesome, especially for us since we take these meals on the go. So if we forget a container at work or like it breaks or something, I'm not using like my most expensive, nicest containers. All right, moving on. I don't really care much about like exact portions, so I don't weigh everything like exactly because I don't track calories or macros. I just keep an eye on protein. And how I do that is I just look at the protein in the ingredients divided by 9. So super, super easy. I have my little one with me and she apparently really loves this mic. She's like really into it. So she's chatting here with me. All right. So again, I don't really care about measurements. I don't track calories, macros, anything like that. I just keep an eye on protein, just a specific goal. Since I am working out a lot, it does make me feel better. And my doctor had told me it was the best thing to track for recovery because let's be honest, nobody has a problem eating carbs or fats, but we always slack on our proteins. So it's just an easy thing for me to keep track of. These meals are super easy. Again, you can throw them in the freezer if you want. I feel like this spaghetti is so good compared to regular spaghetti. I don't know. I'm just like really into it. I like the high protein because it just adds a little bit more protein. So just to give you guys an idea, the spaghetti meal is 30 grams of protein. The pancake bake is 33 grams of protein and the breakfast sandwiches are 20 grams of protein. So just like that, I'm hitting half of my protein goal and I hope you have a wonderful day. I'll see you again next time. Bye-bye.